It's a picture that received national attention, surfacing last week after four white CSU students wore blackface. The female student says it was anti-blemish cream, but words on the photo turned it racial, with a reference to the movie Black Panther. On Wednesday, it was standing room only as President Joyce McConnell took the mic at a student government meeting.
We will show the world that we can come together and that we can make this a place where all students thrive.
McConnell says the First Amendment prevents her from punishing those in this picture frustrating students.
We're just tired of it.
African American students tell us racism and bigotry are nothing new on the CSU campus.
I want to thank you for taking your time to come to see the new president and help me understand what has gone on before I arrived.
There is racial slurs, homophobic slurs, plastered on the walls.
Fourth-year student Giselle Baer says CSU's email response to the blackface episode was the straw that broke the camel's back.
So much more can be done still. An email is not going to do anything.
Students made clear at this meeting the post is painful.
You do not get to define the impact you have created.
McConnell has called on students and faculty to propose initiatives aimed at combating racism on campus.
This is an opportunity for students to come together, to hear from one another.
For those who say the frustration here has been blown out of proportion, African American students we spoke with say, if you don't have black or brown skin, you don't know what it's like.
The best way would just be educating yourselves as well as, you know, asking questions.
You need to swallow pride and try to begin to understand the hurt you have caused. Positive intentions do not outweigh negative impacts.